Good morning, students. Welcome to new class. In today's class, we will start with a new chapter, that is Nazism and Rise of Hitler, class 9th, history. In this session, we will cover the following topics: birth of Weimar Republic, the effect of the war, and the year of depression. So let us start. Nazism was a political ideology which flourished in Germany and influenced world politics. When genocidal war started in Germany under the shadow of Second World War, it caused killing of millions of people in different inhuman ways. This chapter deals with Nazi's ideology, Hitler's politics, and its impact on Germany as well as world's socio-political economic system. Now we proceed to our first topic, that is birth of Weimar Republic. Germany was a powerful empire in the early years of the 20th century. It fought the First World War, that is 1914 to 1918, alongside the Austrian Empire and against the Allies, that are England, France and Russia. Germany made initial gains in the war by occupying France and Belgium. The Allies were threatened by the US entry in 1917. They defeated Germany and the Central Powers in November in 1918. The defeat of Imperial Germany and the resigning of the Emperor gave an opportunity to parliamentary parties to recast German polity. A national assembly met at Weimar and established a democratic constitution with a federal structure. Deputies were elected to the German parliament or Reichstag on the basis of equal and universal votes cast by all adults, including women. Now, Peace Treaty of Versailles. The peace treaty with the Allies was a harsh and humiliating peace. By signing the peace treaty, Germany lost its overseas colonies, 1/10 of its population and 13% of its territories, 75% of its iron and 26% of its coal to France, Poland, Denmark and Lithuania. $6 billion as compensation for war. The war guilt clause held Germany responsible for the war and damages the Allied countries suffered, and the resource-rich Rhineland to Allied control. Further, the Allied powers asked Germany to weaken its power. Many Germans held the new Weimar Republic responsible for not only the defeat in the war but the disgrace at Versailles. Now come the effects of the war. The First World War both psychologically and financially affected Europe, and Europe became a continent of debtor from creditor. The Weimar Republic carried the burden of war guilt and national humiliation. It was forced to pay a huge compensation. Socialist Catholics and Democrats who supported the Weimar Republic were criticized and came to be known as November Criminal by the conservative nationalists, who were not in the favor of all the above three ideas. After the First World War, soldiers were placed above civilians and the media glorified their trench life. However, the truth was just the opposite. They lived miserable life in trenches. Aggressive war propaganda, national honor and support grew for conservative dictatorship. At that time in Europe, democracy was a young and fragile idea which could not survive. Political radicalism and economic crisis. The birth of the Weimar Republic coincided with the revolutionary uprising of the Spartacist League. This league was based on the pattern of the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia. Soviets of workers and sailors were established in many cities. The political atmosphere in Berlin was charged with demands for Soviet-style governance. The Weimar Republic crushed the uprising of the Spartacist League with the help of the war veterans organization called the Free Corps. The Spartans later founded the Communist Party of Germany. The two parties of communist and socialist never worked together after this. Thus, they could not control the rise of Hitler. Then come the economic crisis in Germany. Political radicalization was only increased by the economic crisis of 1923. Germany had fought the war largely on loans and had to pay war reparation in gold. This depleted gold reserves at a time when resources were scarce. When Germany refused to pay in 1923, France occupied Germany's industrial area, the Ruhr, which was rich in coal. Then it came the hyperinflation in Germany. Germany printed paper currency abundantly. It resulted in a sharp fall of the value of German mark, due to which prices of goods increased. This crisis came to be known as hyperinflation in Germany. At last, the American introduced the Dawes Plan. It helped Germany to overcome the crisis. The plan reworked the terms of reparation to ease the financial burden on Germany. This all was the economic crisis, hyperinflation in Germany, which made Germany more miserable at that time. The year of depression. The great economic depression after the First World War caused sharp fall in demands of essential goods. Farmers, traders, and industrialists were severely affected by this crisis. Even America could not escape from this crisis. The Fall Street Exchange crashed in 1929. In Germany, investment and industrial recovery were totally dependent on the USA. Over the next 3 years, that is between 1929 and 1932, the national income of the USA fell by half. The effect of this recession in the US economy were felt all over the world. The Germany economy was severely hit by the economic crisis, and by 1932 industrial production was reduced to 40% of that of 1929 level. Now, what are the main effects of recession on Germany? Workers lost their jobs or their wages were reduced. The number of unemployment people increased to 6 billion. On the street of Germany, men started moving with placards around their necks saying, willing to do any work. Unemployment increases. Unemployed youth played cards or simply sat at street corner or desperately went up at the local employment exchange. As jobs disappeared, the youth took to criminal activities and total disappear became common. The economic crisis created deep anxiety and fear in people. Every member of the society was affected by this economic crisis and was filled with the fear of proletarianism. And it created the instability of Weimar Republic also. The Weimar Constitution had some internal defects which made it unstable and vulnerable to dictatorship. Due to proportional representation, it was impossible to get a majority for one single party. Moreover, Article 48 gave the president the power to impose emergency, suspend civil rights, and rule by decree. The Weimar Republic faced 20 different cabinets in 14 years, each lasting on average 239 days, and people lost confidence in the democratic parliamentary system, which hardly offered any solutions. That's it with today's session. Tomorrow we will start our session with the Hitler's rise to power. Till then, take care. Goodbye.